I'd love to come to one of your shows.
Oh my God, yeah, that would be an honor, sure. I'm going to go to your show tonight.
So, oh, great.
So
great.
I'm pretty excited about
it. Yeah, well, we'll do swap.
Yeah. When you're done with me, I see negative space. What you've done for me, you need to
hallucinate. I'm quite obsessed with lyrics. No Name's probably someone who I'd like to work with, just because every time I listen to one of her songs, I spend the rest of the day mulling over one of the lyrics, and she's definitely very thought-provoking. Mm.
There's one person for me that's always been sort of a constant part of my mood board or something, which is actually Andre 3000. Mm. So I thought that was, like, for me, he's really sort of so important in terms of, style.
Yes.
And in terms of the energy that he's sort of actually brought around.
We perform the song Where's the Catch that we made, and every time we perform it, Rob triggers a sample of him rapping. And every time it happens, I sort of have this weird out-of-body moment where I go,
yeah, I bet.
He's on my track, what? Yeah. Inside, I'm screaming.
Yeah. I'm going to let you start with that. I'm sure your story was a lot more interesting.
I was working with someone who, and he was completely right to do it, but, he was working on a song and I was there with a friend. It's the first time anyone's ever been this direct to me, but they just said, could you leave? And then I thought about it, and I did leave, obviously. It could have worked on his tack, probably.
Yeah, maybe.
But, yeah.
2 weeks ago, I think for me it's a very constant thing that I have. Mm. I'm probably more in a slum most of the time.
It's traumatic.
It is kind of.
Yeah. Being social actually helps me with that.
It's sometimes even backstage at the show, someone will ask, so what about next season?
And you're like, what? And it's your name as well. Like, I can imagine there's a lot of pressure on, it must be a similar pressure to people coming up to you and saying, where's the next album? Because it's your name, people can just come direct to the source
and ask
where it's coming from.
I know that the seasons where I felt most pressured, when I look back at it, that's some of the seasons that just came out the best.
It also is a testament to your sort of constitution that you can actually work well under that kind of pressure. Like, the fear of what people would think was crippling. I think it's easy to overthink the importance of people's reactions and stuff like that.
I did, when I was at the Royal College, I actually did my master thesis there about how music is sort of, how it can influence you in a creative process. Everything is said in that show music sometimes.
Off-White does that well, I think. I think Virgil does that well. Yeah. Love to come to a show because I haven't actually seen one yet. But there are certain days, and I've had this with certain artists as well, wearing a certain costume or a certain outfit depending on what they want to record that day. There's one rapper who comes to mind where it was like, we were recording some quite kind of beautiful, sensitive, introspective music, and he was dressed a certain way that day. And then there was a day where he just was like, no, now I want to come in and do something completely different. And he came in dressed almost the opposite. Like, it was gregarious, like, ostentatious dress sense. And it was amazing because it really put him in the zone to basically speak his mind like that.
When I started my brand, I wasn't really social media. I need to kind of protect myself in some situations.
I actually resonate with that on the level of the sort of public versus private.
Yeah.
I created a kind of persona or at least an aesthetic that maybe was a little more mysterious than I actually am. Maybe better dressed than I am in real life. Or maybe, do you know what I mean? There's a lot of things about myself that I think if I were completely honest, weren't really matching up.
One of the reasons as well was I was kind of nervous about meeting you as well, is that I just super admire how what you do is just so important for people's well-being. You know, like that there are artists that just produces something because they just know how to create something beautiful.
Well, thank you. I mean, I think actually musicians are kind of almost mythologized a little bit. And our kind of power is maybe overstated because in actual fact, like once I've finished making a track, I just go and, you know, do the same sort of self-sabotaging shit that everybody else does. London for me is a mixed bag because it's like you, when you grow up here, you have all of your associations all at once. And that's kind of amazing, actually, because it's history. One little moment before the show last night, me and Ben and Rob walked down the river. We walked down to the river, Thames. It was beautiful. It was a real moment of appreciation for the city. You know, Brixton, St. Matthew's Church in Brixton, I think it's called. But we call it Brixton Mass because that's where Digital Mystics had their birthdays and their nights that we all went to, and so Brixton has a kind of, you know, a resonance for me as well.
Yeah, it's funny, a lot of people ask that.
Chill out, probably be my yeah. my one. I just overthought a lot of things that I could have just
for sure
enjoyed in the moment, and I didn't.
Yeah.
And I wish I hadn't done that.